Well, I knew the school when it was an all-Irish school, when it had a Bunscoil and senior school together. When I did the Leaving Cert, there were 9 pupils in my class. And then the great growth came through the 60s with free education and that. People were looking forward and they felt that Irish maybe was something that was holding us back. And there came a time in about 1973 when the numbers began to drop in our school. A number of solutions were put forward, and probably the best solution of all was arrived at in the end, and that was to make 2 schools, in effect, what we used to call the Scoil Gaeilge, and then the rest of the school in which the instruction would be to the medium of English. And the Scoil Gaeilge would take in girls. There was a decision that, or at least there was talk about changing the school completely to a co-educational school. I was very much in favour of it. Others weren't, but I could always see their view. And even to this day, people can argue cogently for single-sex education. I wouldn't have been an advocate of that. I think that we made an excellent decision. And there again, we made it on the basis that we would not operate on a 50-50 gender balance, that it would perhaps be 40-60. And that was a gesture towards the extracurricular activities in the school, sport and so on. How would you have a meaningful, how could you have a decent football team if your numbers were depleted to the extent that it would happen? Because not everybody is a good footballer, so to speak. How would we remain competitive? But by and large, I think luck was on our side. We got very talented, very bright, very strong females into the school, and they developed their own sports codes and so on, and they were competitive there. The Jesuits were wise when they thought that, well, co-education would be a very suitable and a very appropriate response to the Galway scene, and I think it was with their support, as well as, I suppose, the resources on the ground, that made it such a success.
The demands in terms of sports, in terms of out-of-school activities and so on, to provide for everybody, also gave the opportunity to fill out the basic Ignatian idea that education is experience, and that experience is to do with encountering people in a whole wide variety of manners and contexts and so on. The fact that Coláiste Ignóid is a Jesuit school is of immense importance. This became more and more part of my thinking as I went on. I mean, I was more and more informed as I went on, and more impressed by the fact that Coláiste Ignóid, as one of 5 Jesuit schools in Ireland, is one of thousands of schools all over the world. The Jesuit yearbook would show you what was happening in Manila, what was happening in various parts of America in Jesuit schools. There was a constant flow of information, reports, visitors, and so on. So you were always aware that you were part of a very large family, and that even if the languages were different, the vocabulary was more or less the same. The approach to youngsters was the same. The approach to learning was the same. The excitement of learning was that which was stressed all the time. The whole business of corporal punishment and so on had been banned, and people were developing new ways of relating to people in schools, and it was becoming more and more obvious all over that, for instance, good discipline would depend on good relationships. Now, that was something which was well known in Jesuit schools. Anyway, the most rewarding thing would have been to find situations where patience was rewarded, where putting trust in the essential goodness of people, which would emerge, that was rewarded time after time after time.